Magdeburg, Blood Wedding, 1631. A City in Flames. No event in the 30 Years' War makes history like the destruction of Magdeburg. The attack is almost representative of the war and is regarded as the darkest testimony to its violent madness. For contemporaries, it is particularly terrible. Traumas and fears spread, Magdeburg becomes a specter, a symbol of the omnipresent decay and the insecurity of violent attacks. Even the word Magdeburgizing becomes commonplace and describes total destruction. It is May 20, 1631. 22,000 of Tilly's imperial soldiers gather in front of the city walls. They are joined by around 6,000 mercenaries under the leadership of his deputy, Pappenheim. The city in front of them is one of the largest and richest cities of the time. Its strategic location and fertile cornfields make it a coveted object. The problem? Early on, the people of Magdeburg decided in favor of Martin Luther's teachings. Catholics were clearly in the minority. Nevertheless, the city tried to maintain its neutrality during the war. Now the plan seems to be crumbling. Despite the impending danger from Johann von Tilly, the people of Magdeburg decide against the offer of surrender. They hope for support from the Swedish army. Around 7 a.m., the time has come. Johann von Tilly wants to take the city by force. A heavy bombardment hits Magdeburg first. The soldiers, especially the Pappenheimers, then enter the city. They are the ones who quickly start to light fires, which have a venerating effect during the course of the conquest. The sudden defenselessness of the inhabitants of Magdeburg prompted the Pappenheim soldiers to take a particularly violent stance. They are no longer masters of their senses and spread unimagined horror in the city. The most horrific crimes suffered by the people of Magdeburg in this terrible hour of European history were the impaling of babies and the endless rape of girls and women. The brutality of the soldiers was said to be so merciless that even Tilly and Pappenheim were shocked and incomprehensible. It was not their intention to destroy the strategically favorable town. Their intention was to capture it for their own purposes, but the soldiers overrode them and razed the city to the ground. Even the right of asylum in the churches was abolished. Only the few who took refuge in Magdeburg Cathedral were spared by the soldiers. In the end, most of the buildings have disappeared, giving way to epidemics and the smell of decay. Of the original 35,000 inhabitants, around 450 remain in the end.